Okay, okay, so yesterday we learned in the Bchinas Raglayim, that the Raglayim, they represent the Dinim, and they also represent the Chasodim, what that's weakened. Today we'll learn that it's also Bchinas Yadayim. Also, the bechina of clapping the hands is mevatel the gaiva and the avodah zarah. Kedei ruach, that the ruach of the holiness, which is in the heart, that spreads out to the spiritual hands of the person. What happens is it's the revelation of the illumination of the hands. That means that the aspects of Yadayim, which are in the Nefesh, which are in the soul, is elevated and it glows, it illuminates. It's true that the main unique, or the main feeding off of the Klipas is from the Raglayim, is from the legs, because these are the lowest, they go down. They're very close to the chitzeri, they're close to the outsiders. But from the Yadayim, which is a much higher mechino, they have no unique, they cannot suckle from there. However, every place that the chitzerinim, you know, surge ahead, the illumination of the hands is also becomes concealed, you can't see it. Because the feeding of the chitzonim is from the dinim that come from the gvura, and the gvura ultimately is called yad smol, it's called the left hand. And when you clap the hands, it reveals the aura of the yadayim again. When the chitzonim overcome, the revelation of the hands disappear. Because where chitzonim come, because there's too much verse come from the hand. When you clap the hands, you're putting together the left and the right, the verse with the chasodim. This allows the revelation of the hands to come again. Kmo shekosuv kol doidi doifik. The voice of my uncle, of my beloved, is knocking. Doifek also means pulse. It's pulsating. The voice of my beloved is pulsating. Doifek zebchinas ruach. The pulse is the ruach, as it says in the Tikkunim. In other words, what is alluded to it is that the spirit of Hashem is pulsating by a person to awaken his heart. Tum, tum. Boom. Every day, look at what happens. You know, there was an accident, Lo Aleinu, that Rav Auschwitz's son was in an accident.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was there was a little girl. Mm-hmm. So, open up your eyes and see. Open up your eyes and see. The Samichle, immediately after he says that Hashem's voice is knocking, is pulsing you to awaken a person. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, in the Pasuk, initially, Rashi says, what is Doidi in Shir HaShirim, the Song of Songs? My beloved sent his hand from the hall. Says, Rashi says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has sent his hand and shown his nekama, his revenge to Am Yisrael that would not withdraw from Avodah Zarah. What it says here is that they allude, what this alludes to is the Doidi, my beloved, the Kodesh Baruch Hu, is Sholoch Yodai. What he is sending forth is the Pechidas Yadayim. The Ruach Kodesh Baruch Hu is being drawn to the Yadayim. Ze b'chinas isgalus oras Yadayim. This is the revelation of the Yadayim. Hayinu b'chiyas b'chiyas kaf. This is the clapping of the hands through which when a person comes close to the tzaddik and receives from him Ruach HaKadusha, is being drawn to the hands. And when with this, a person claps his hand, and with the clapping of the hands, he draws the Ruach HaKadusha, HaKadusha also, to his spiritual hands. And what does is, V'az nisbata l'avod azorah ha'inu firuz. This cancels out the avod azorah, the heresies. Because the heresies, the dinim, were feeding off the hand small, the left hand. And
that's the
when you clap the hand, this cancels out the kfiras, cancels out the avodah zarah. And then the hand, the aspect of hands shines. And then the yadayim represent the emunah. This is what the Son of Akash Rabbi in the time of the war with Amalek, when he lifted his hands to the sky, the Yodov Emuno, and his hands were Emuno. This, from here you know that the hands represent the Bechina of Emuno. The Yadayim, I don't know if you remember, but everybody talks about the Torah above, we learned it once before. The Yadayim, there are three meanings to Yadayim. There is Begashmius, there is Beruchnius, conceptually, and there is beruchnius of a higher madrega. Begashmius, the hands are klei ha'maaseh. The hands are what you do, you know, the tools which you use to work. You're working with your hands, right? Beruchnius, the Yadayim represents in tefillah, the Yadav, you know, you spread your hands in supplication, right? Please help me, help me, help me.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. This is the opposite of the Yadayim Begashmius. Gashmius is I can do. Kechivat Semyodi, I can do. Tefillah means I can help you, you do for me, please. Right? So Yadayim Beruchnius is the opposite of Yadayim Begashmius. Yadayim Beruchnius is please. And then there's a higher Bechina, as we said, this is the Yadayim Shebiyad HaChochma, the hands, which are the tools to receive, to impart knowledge in the sea of wisdom. We said that words, I don't know if you remember that, but words have a limited capacity to denote information, to bring over information. When I say big, you understand, okay, big. When I say small, small, okay. But how big or small, you know, but if I go big, if I go big, you have a bigger understanding of what big means. If I say small, I say small, you know, one thing, when I say small, in other words, the hands can hint information that the words cannot convey. Ramazan, they deal with much finer subtleties. Says the Yadayim Shabiyam HaChochma. It says, but the Chachomim, the Yadayim are the receptacles. The Yadayim, the spiritual Yadayim, are the vessels with which receives chokhmah, you know, mitzamtzem chokhmah v'yama chokhmah. Also implants chokhmah, you know, because you can hint and do with your yadayim and explain that which you're saying with greater precision and finesse when you're using your hands. So don't ask me why I'm talking with your hands all the time. I talk with hands all the time. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. Nimtza shavdei ha-tzadik shu b'chinas ruach shabalev. So you can see this is there profound. That's through the tzadik who represents the spirit, the wind in the heart. The illumination of the hands and the legs is being revealed. This is dancing and clapping the hands. And that brings about when it's batel ha-gaiva b'kfirus. And that cancels out the gaiva and the heresy. When it's rabbi muno and the belief and faith is being multiplied, my foot stood in the misha, shubchinas emuno. Standing straight is called emuno, kiminus, in other words, heresy, ibchinas nakayo raglai, my legs are bent, they're not straight. Kimamar Asaf, and it says, Kimat Natayu Raglai, my legs were always bent, almost faltered, almost fell off the emunah. Sheneemar Shama Shesio Libo Leminus, my heart, his heart, you know, cajoled him into heresy. And it says that Asaf, you know, laments over there that he almost was almost in, you know, in deep trouble. And he says, I know the old, what he said over there, I know the old problems from Israel, they come to the Tevas, the Bizoche Te'olim Abba. He says, but I, he says over there, before I actually paid attention to this, he says in this Tehillim, my heart almost pulled me to Minus, to heresy. I started being, you know, I was jealous for the Rishon, look at them. They go and eat Club 21, they all go to Copacabana, they're eating, you know, fat steaks with shrimp cocktails and stuff, and they're robbing banks, and then all kinds of good stuff happening to them.
We're in the year 2015. We're like 1977.
That's probably 1930s, more like. I don't know. He says, I was jealous of all those who are, you know, going clubbing, you know, and taking ecstasy and whatever it is. You know, they're succeeding, they have shalom, you know, the big stars, the movie stars and singing stars and all kinds of stuff. So you see for me it's an entire raglai that my legs were bent. He says it means he almost came to heresy. So you see that heresy is called bent legs. Ruggly on the mishur, but when I'm saying that my leg stood, you know, on a mishur, this, Moira Alamuno, this, when the legs are straight, it means that the Zohar is away, so, and then in the Raglai Hezamuna. V'az Niskayim, then this brings about to a state, Ve'i Yodov Emuna. Now it's very well understood what the Rebbe said in the beginning, when there's Chas Shalom Din Olam Yisrael, by dancing and clapping the hands, you make up Tokas Adini. Because when a person comes close to the tzaddik and receives from him the Ruach HaKodesh, Ruach HaKdusha, he is awakened to great simcha, and then he's coming to dancing and to clapping the hands, and it brings about the sweetening and amtoko of the dinim. Until here for today.